To draw the shear force and bending moment diagram of the falling beam that is connected with a pin at point B, we can start by first figuring out the support reactions. So here we have at point A a rocker. It will have a support reaction going vertically upward direction. Next, we have a fixed support at point D. Since we don't have any horizontal load, so we don't have to worry about the support reaction in the x direction. However, we will have a support reaction in the y as well as the coupled moment M. Next, we can figure out these support reactions by first considering section AB of the beam. So let's draw the free body diagram. Here I have my AY going vertically upward. Next, I have a 15 kilopound load that is acting vertically downward, 3 feet from point A. Next, I have a coupled moment of 8 kilopound fit in the clockwise direction. And finally, we have a pin at point B, so we will expose the internal forces of Px and By. Next, in order to solve for Ay, we can write our equilibrium condition of summation of moment at point B equals to 0. So force Ay will create a moment in the clockwise direction, that's why we have a negative, whereas the 15 kilopound force will create a moment in the counterclockwise direction and have a moment arm of 6, whereas our coupled moment is in the clockwise direction, so it will be negative 8. Since the summation of moment is equals to 0, we can figure out the value of Ay, that is coming 9.11 kilopounds. Next, we can figure out the support reactions at point D by considering the whole beam. So this distributive loading of 500 pounds per foot can be converted into a point load by multiplying that 500 pounds per foot to 12 feet. That gives us a 6 kilopound load that will be acting in the middle of that distributive loading. So we can apply the equilibrium equation, that is summation of forces along the y direction equals to 0. This gives us the value of dy, that is coming 11.89 kilopounds. The second equation we can use is the summation of moment. So let's do that at point D. So writing the summation of moment at point D and taking counterclockwise moment as positive, we will have an expression of negative 9.11, that is the load at point A, which have a moment arm of 21. Since it is going to create a clockwise moment, that's why we have the negative value. Next, we have a point load of 15 kilopounds that have a moment arm of 18. That will create a counterclockwise moment. Next, I have the coupled moment of 8 kilopound fit that is going in the clockwise direction. And finally, the distributive load that is be converted into a point load of 6 kilopound that have a moment arm of 6 feet. So that will create our counterclockwise moment. And finally, we have our coupled moment at point D as M. Simplifying, we get the value of M as 106.67 kilopounds fit. Now let's go ahead and draw our shear force diagram. In this problem, we will utilize the graphical method and utilize the loading acting on the beam to draw our shear force diagram. So let's start with point A. We have a load of 9.11 kilopounds going vertically upward. That will cause a jump up on our shear force diagram from 0 to 9.11. Next, I have a point load of 15 kilopounds that is acting vertically downward. That will cause a jump down from 9.11. We subtract 15 and we get negative 5.89. After that, we don't have any other loading from 15 kilopounds till point C, so we will have a flat line. Next, I have a distributive loading of 50 pounds per foot, and that goes over till 12 feet on the beam. We need to figure out the area that distributive loading is forming under that curve. So calculating the area, it comes around 6 kilopound, meaning our shear force diagram will go down further 6 kilopounds as it reaches point D. So subtracting 6 from negative 5.89, we have a value of negative 11.89 at point D. Next, we have to figure out what will be the profile of the shear force diagram from C to D. Since the slope of the distributive loading is zero, we will have a linear profile going from C to D as we integrate to get that area. Finally, I have a point load of 11.89 kilopound at point D that will cause a jump up on my shear force diagram and it goes back to zero. Now let's go ahead and draw our bending moment diagram. So we will utilize the area under the curve of shear force diagram to figure out the bending moment. So starting at point A, we have our rectangular area that we can get by multiplying 9.11 with 3 feet, and that value is coming as 27.33, meaning that the bending moment value will be at 27.33, 3 feet from A. Next, we have to figure out what will be the profile, how this bending moment is changing from the very end at point A to 3 feet from it. Since I have a slope of 0 on my shear force diagram in that zone, the bending moment diagram will have a linear profile. Next, we look at the second rectangular area, that is from 3 feet at point A all the way to 7 feet from point A. So if you look, I have an area of negative 5.89 times 4. So we need to subtract this area from 27.33, and that gives us a value of 3.78. Next, still we have to figure out the profile. Again, since the slope is 0, I will have a linear profile going down this time because my area is negative. After that, we have our couple moment of 8 kilopound fit acting in the clockwise direction. Now, whenever we have a couple moment going in the clockwise direction, there is a jump up on the bending moment diagram. So our value on the bending moment diagram will jump up from 3.78 plus 8 kilopound fit. That gives us the value of 11.78 kilopound fit. Next, we have this small rectangular area as well that is going from the couple moment till point C. And the value of it can be calculated by multiplying negative 5.89 with 2. So doing the math and subtracting that area from the 11.78 give us the value of 0. So our bending moment diagrams comes down from 11.78 to 0 in the linear fashion again. After that, from point C to D, I have this shear force diagram in which I have to figure out what is the area under the curve. So I can divide this into two zones to figure out my area easily. I can have one rectangle and one triangle. So the total area of these two regions is coming around as negative 106.7, which means that my bending moment diagram will go from 0 at point C to negative 106.7 at point D. Now, to figure out the profile, since on the shear force diagram we have the linear profile, on the bending moment diagram I have the quadratic profile since we integrate to get the bending moment diagram. Finally, I have my couple moment of 106.67 in the clockwise direction that will cause the jump up on my bending moment diagram and will go from negative 106.7 all the way to 0,